Good morning, everyone. Can anyone tell me up to which point we have covered? I think we have seen Frenet apparatus, no? Either I have given you any example for the homework?
No, ma'am.
Okay, whether you solve that example or example of a helix, where you have to verify whether you, whatever the values of tangent, normal, binormal, all these are same which we have calculated for a unit speed. Yes, whether you have verified, have you solved
yes,
that
ma'am.
Example?
Yes, ma'am.
By arbitrary speed curve formulas. Okay. So, any doubt for solving all these examples from unit speed or arbitrary speed curve? And
no,
whether
ma'am.
You have any doubt about the geometric interpretation? Doubt hai ka kai, what are the actual use of these apparatus and all? If you have a doubt about geometric interpretation or anything else, you can ask. Because now we are going to next point. Okay, I hope you are not having a doubt. Now let us go for the next point, that is isometry in R3. Actually, this concept you have already studied in a functional analysis, isometry in E3 or R3 space. So the isometry is a rigid motion of a Euclidean space in a, it is a special type of a mapping which preserves the Euclidean distance between the two points, right? What do you mean by this definition? Simply the meaning of this definition is difference between the two points, images of two points, say P and Q, and difference between the two actual points P and Q are same, and this is true for every point P and Q belongs to E3. And if this condition is satisfied, the mapping F is said to be a isometry, right? F is a mapping from E3 to E3 space. And this mapping, if it's going to satisfy the condition D of distance between FP and FQ is exactly equal to the distance between P and Q, then we say that this is an isometry. The isometry is, it is a rigid motion of a Euclidean space. It is nothing but a one spatial type of a mapping which preserves the Euclidean distance. Okay, what do you mean by this distance between images is equal to distance between that point? That means it is going to save the, or we can say it is going to preserve the Euclidean distance. Jahan pe points ke beech mein jo distance hai, usi ko usne preserve karke images ke beech mein ka bhi distance utna hi hai. Correct? So, here we know that what is distance between P and Q, we can calculate it is nothing but norm of P minus Q or mod of P minus Q. Okay, so here the definition of this ensures that this is nothing but the distance preserving function. Okay, now here we are going to see the types of this. Majorly there are so many types, and out of them I will show you the first one is translation. Then rotation and orthogonal transformation. Orthogonal transformation. Okay, so in this unit we are going to study the three types of isometry. There are actually so many types of isometry, as well as we have a real life examples of isometry. Right, let me show you how the real life examples are there later on. But up to then, firstly, suppose if you want to understand what is an isometry, suppose actually we are going to study everything in E3 space. Suppose I have one curve like this. So I should have a very similar curve here. So this is called isometry. And again, suppose you are in a 2D plane. And if you want to draw y is equal to mod x. Right, y is equal to mod x. What is a graph? Like this, no? And here I have another graph, y is equals to mod of x minus a. So these are looking very similar, no? Whatever may be the distance between any two points here, the exact distance will be between these two points, correct? And similarly, the very easy example for this one is, suppose I have a line here, say y equal to 2, correct? And suppose I have some another point where I am going to start it at, say y, you can say it is y1. So Suppose this is what a y2, 2 plus c. So whatever may be the distance, यहाँ के line में दो points का जो distance होगा, obviously that distance will be preserved because c is a constant term, so you can take a difference between any two points will be same. समझते हैं सगळ्यांना?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Okay. So let me start with the definition. What do you mean by definition of isometry? If F is a mapping from E3 to E3, then if the distance between the images is exactly equal to the distance between the point, right? So first we are going to calculate the distance between the two points. And if same distance is carried out between the images of those points, right? That means if F is a mapping from E3 to E3, P and Q are points from here, and what is F of P, F of Q are the points from the codomain, right? So distance between the two points P and Q exactly equal to distance between F of P and F of Q, okay? And if this preserve, that means we can say distance preserving function. So this is called a isometry. If this condition satisfy, then the function F is called a isometry in E3. Right now here actually there are so many types of isometry, but mainly in the differential geometry we will see translation, rotation and orthogonal transformation. No doubt later on we will see in detail what is translation, what is a definition and theorem, some theorem on translation, some theorem on rotation and orthogonal transformation. And later on we will prove that translation is isometry, rotation is isometry and orthogonal transformation is also isometry. Just now, just remember that these are types of isometry which we are going to study. इतने ही types नहीं है, but हमारे differential geometry में सिर्फ हम ये तीन types study करेंगे, okay? Later on, we will see all those theorems related to these types. And here you can see the similarity. Suppose this is what one graph. Here is also one graph. So you can see the images, okay? So you can say mirror images is also one type of isometry, right? Here mod x is function, another is mod of x minus 2. So both the graph are looking very same, and if you calculate the distance between these two points, the distance between these two points is exactly equal to the distance between these two points. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट डिस्टेंस प्रिजर्विंग फंक्शन. सो यहाँ पे भी हमने क्या है, ड्रॉ किया है y इक्वल टू, सपोज y1 इज इक्वल टू 2 इज अ ग्राफ, एंड हियर फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव स्टडीड y2 इज इक्वल टू 2 प्लस c. अगर यहाँ पे हमने किसी टू पॉइंट्स का डिस्टेंस लिया एंड द इमेज अगर हमने कैलकुलेट किया, राइट? सो दिस c माइनस c प्लस c विल गेट कैंसिल, अगेन यू गेट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स in y1 is exactly equal to the distance between the two points in y2. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Sirf humne ek translation perform kiya hai. I think you have done this in the complex analysis in detail. Kehna na complex madhe translation.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, in the very similar way, yahan to hum sirf 3D space mein dekh rahe hain, wahan pe complex analysis मैं हमने स्टडी किया है, कॉम्प्लेक्स एनालिसिस में टाइप्स ऑफ दोज आइसोमेट्री, दैट ट्रांसलेशन एंड ऑल, राइट? सो लेट मी शो यू वन रियल लाइफ एग्जांपल इन विच वी हैव अ कंसेप्ट ऑफ आइसोमेट्री, बट डोंट रिलेट इट विथ अवर डिफरेंशियल ज्योमेट्री, क्योंकि हम डिफरेंशियल ज्योमेट्री में सिर्फ तीन टाइप देख रहे हैं, राइट? सो एक्चुअली वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू वॉक, नाउ डोंट लाफ हियर, माई ड्रॉइंग इज नॉट सो गुड. अगर आप वॉक कर रहे हो, सपोज दिस इज योर फर्स्ट लेग एंड सपोज दिस इज सेकेंड वन एंड दिस इज व्हाट द थर्ड वन, तो यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड आर सेम, क्योंकि उसका आइसोमेट्री सेम है ना. अगर यहाँ पे हमने जो भी देखा है, सो एग्जैक्टली सेम विल बी देयर इन द थर्ड वॉक, और यू कैन से जितना आप स्टार्टिंग में चल रहे हो, राइट? द फर्स्ट स्टेप, सेकेंड स्टेप एंड थर्ड स्टेप. सो फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड स्टेप आर सेम. समझ से का?
यस मैम.
So here, suppose we want to see the mirror images, right? If you stand in front of mirror, so you can see your own image. But what is the exact difference there is, आपका जो राइट हैंड आपको यहाँ पे दिखता है वो उधर वाले का, या अगर हम इमेजिन कर रहे कि वो मिरर में कोई दूसरा पर्सन है, उसका वो राइट हैंड नहीं होगा, इट विल बी लेफ्ट हैंड ऑफ दैट मैन, करेक्ट नो?
यस मैम,
तो बट एक्चुअली वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू सी, सपोज दिस इज वन पर्सन हियर एंड हियर इज द मिरर इमेज, राइट? बट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंट. सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू पॉइंट, एंड ऑब्वियसली द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू पॉइंट्स एंड दीज विल बी एग्जैक्टली सेम. वाई? बिकॉज इट इज अ मिरर इमेज. सो यू कैन से डिस्टेंस बिटवीन पी एंड क्यू एग्जैक्टली इक्वल टू द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द मिरर इमेजेस, से एम ऑफ पी एंड एम ऑफ क्यू. एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ अ फंक्शन इज कॉल्ड अ आइसोमेट्री. ओके, एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ आइसोमेट्री. द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ योर वॉक, सेकेंड एंड थर्ड. अगेन यू कैन सी सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ स्टेप ऑफ योर वॉक आर सेम. ओके, ट्राई टू इमेजिन, आप अगर चल रहे हो तो वो इमेजिन करके देखिए, आपका फर्स्ट और थर्ड स्टेप सेम होता है, करेक्ट? नाउ हियर ऑल्सो इन सी वी कैन सी द इमेजेस ऑफ मिरर इमेजेस एज वेल एज यू कैन हैव द इमेजेस इन वॉटर. सपोज द वॉटर इज देयर एंड इफ यू आर स्टैंडिंग हियर, सो यू कैन सी योर ओन इमेज इन द वॉटर, करेक्ट? दैट इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ अ आइसोमेट्री, दैट इज अ डिस्टेंस प्रिजर्विंग फंक्शन. ओके, नाउ शुड आई गो फॉर द टाइप्स ऑफ आइसोमेट्री? इज देयर एनी डाउट फॉर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ आइसोमेट्री ऑन हाई, और वी कैन सी हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक एंड ऑल?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
So let us go for the types of isometry. The first one we'll see is a translation. Okay. The translation. So for translation is a function which moves at every point with a constant distance in a specified direction. Let me write down the definition. Translation is a function that moves every point with a constant distance in specified direction. With a constant distance in a specified direction, or we can say that it is an addition of a constant vector at every point. And if a suppose a bar is a fixed vector in E3, then the mapping T that adds a bar to every point. Okay, let me show you how it looks. Suppose T of P is there, so P bar plus A, that means for every point P, we are going to add one constant number A, so that whatever the resultant we are getting is a T of P. Okay, just like here I have shown you. Instead of this one, let me show you another. Suppose here is one mapping mod of x plus a. अगर आपको थोड़ा confusion है तो आप खुद calculate करके देखिए, ये mod x होगा, ये mod of x minus a, mod of x plus a. You might thinking that here is a negative, so it should be mod of x minus a. ऐसा वाटते का? काय सांगितले कळालं? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
So if you are having any doubt, you can check out that y it is mod of x minus a, x plus a. क्या करना पड़ेगा आपको? Whatever may be the values of x, for that you have to check the mod x and as well as mod of x minus a, mod of x plus a. A का कुछ एक specified number choose कीजिए अपन, like x minus 2 or x plus 2, then you will understand, right? So here what we have done, this is our original function mod x, and if I am going to add a constant number a to every point of mod x, so whatever the resultant I am getting is a mod of x plus a. So this point is moved with that constant distance here, this point is moved here with a constant distance. So in this way, at every point of your original function, or you can say at every point of your p, is added with some constant number a, and the new function whatever we have been constructed is nothing but your t of p, and this is true for every point p of a E3 space. Okay, so this is what we can say: a translation is a function which moves every point with a constant distance in a specified direction, or we can say that addition of a constant vector at every point. Okay, and if suppose we are having a constant vector is a, so we are adding a to every point p of a E3 space, then the resultant we are getting t of p is equals to p plus a. Is it okay with the definition of a translation?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now what we will do, now actually we have defined the translation. Now let us prove that. We will show that the translation is a isometry. Okay, what is our aim to prove? The translation is isometry. Okay, let us assume that T be the translation given by T of P is equals to P plus A, right? So here we want to prove it is isometry. That is to prove that. What do you mean by to prove isometry? We have to prove that distance between TP and TQ, where what is P and Q? P and Q are any points in E3 space. Then we have to prove that distance between TP and TQ is exactly equal to the distance between P and Q. Okay? Samasya ka?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Distance between P and Q, we have to prove it is equal to distance between TP and TQ. So, hum log distance between P and Q se start nahi kar sakte na. We don't have anything about them. So, let us start with the distance between TP and TQ. So, what will be the distance? We are going to denote it by norm of T of P minus minus T of Q. But what is T of P? T of P by the definition of a function, P plus A. Similarly, what will be T of Q? Q plus A. Because to every point P and Q, P, whatever may be the point, har point mein aapko ek constant number add karna hai. Just like here you get the function. Okay. And if you are confusing, you can see here also. Here is y equal to 2 is a straight line. 2 plus C. Matlab aapne har point ko ek constant distance C se add karke naya function tayar kiya hai. Okay. We have constructed a new function by adding constant number c so that we get a translation. Okay, so here also we have done the same thing, just we have written the value of tp and tq. So now here you can see this a get cancelled, so what I get? Norm of p minus q. But what is your norm of p minus q? It is nothing but distance between p and q, and hence we can say that t is a isometry. Okay, काय केलत कळालं का? इज इट सो डिफिकल्ट?
नो मॅम.
नाव लेट अस गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट डेफिनेशन, दॅट इज रोटेशन इज अ वन टाइप ऑफ आयसोमेट्री ना. लेट अस सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दॅट सेकंड टाइप, rotation around a coordinate axis. Actually, ये हमने already किया है. I hope you remember this. We have done in the classical mechanics in the fourth chapter. आठवते का? सपोज आय हॅव दिस एक्स वाय झेड अँड आय हॅव टू रोटेट विथ सम अन अँगल थीटा, सो एक्स विल बी एट न्यू पोझिशन एक्स डॅश, अँड सपोज वी आर परफॉर्मिंग रोटेशन अबाउट अ झेड एक्सेस, झेड इज इक्वल टू झेड डॅश इज सेम, y is rotated to some y dash with same angle theta. Z is at z dash. We have fixed out z dash, and that is we have fixed our z axis and we have rotated through an angle theta. Yes, everyone remember this? Very big theorem.
Yes, ma'am.
And we have performed the three rotation through theta, phi, and psi. And after that, we have found a 3x3 matrix for every rotation. And after that, we have found the new matrix, which is a combination of all these three rotations. Okay. So if you remember this one, it is easy to understand what is a rotation around a coordinate axis. This is also one type of a isometry. So what you have to do here, here also we will perform a rotation through a z-axis. That means we will keep x and y as it is, right? We will keep x and y and as it is. Suppose this is any point P with an angle theta, and we are going to perform a rotation about a z-axis, okay? So we will perform a rotation about a z-axis, which means that we are going to put a z-axis as it is and we will perform a rotation. So what you do, you have to just imagine that you are wherever you are sitting, there might be any corner. So you have to just plot x, y, z axis and you keep z axis as it is and you rotate this. Okay, आपके घर पे भी तीन ऐसे जो भी कोना होगा आपके घर में वहां पे x, y, z axis plot कर सकते हो ना.
Yes, ma'am.
So whatever is a vertical जो आपके दीवार होगा उसको जो वर्टिकल लाइन है उसको आप जेड एक्सिस अज्यूम करिए एंड पुट जेड एक्सिस एज इट इज एंड यू कैन रोटेट अबाउट अ जेड एक्सिस. दैट मीन्स आप जहाँ पे बैठ रहे हो वो रोटेट होगा, राइट? सो जस्ट इमेजिन दैट यू आर जस्ट गोइंग टू रोटेट थ्रू अ जेड एक्सिस एंड देन जेड विल एक्सिस विल बी एज इट इज, एक्स एंड वाई विल चेंज इट्स पोजिशन. ओके, so here consider the rotation of xy plane about a z axis. So we can say the rotation is along to an angle theta. So let me draw the image for this rotation. What I have to do, this is what your x axis, y axis, and we are performing rotation through z axis. So initially our point was P, yahan pe jaise maine dikhaya hai, right? Our point was some P with, suppose angle is initially we have phi, okay, and we have performed a rotation through an angle theta. That is, suppose the new position is Q, performed through an angle theta, then P with the coordinate say P1, P2, what is this? This is your Q2 and this is what your Q1. Okay, let me show you the distance. This is your Q1 and this whole is a P1. Okay, getting me how we I have drawn the images? Simply maine rotation through an angle theta liya yahan pe and point initially the point P is at the position with the coordinate say P1 and P2 and later on the rotation is performed through an angle theta. So it is at new position say Q with the Q1, Q2. Then we have whatever the coordinates we have along X and Y. So we have plotted them. This is P1, P2 and Q1, Q2. Okay. Whether everyone understood the image, whatever I have drawn, if you haven't understood, I will explain once again. समझ सका?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
तो सिंपल हमने क्या किया है, पॉइंट पी इज विद सम एंगल से फाइव वो कुछ एक पॉइंट पे है एंड देन वी हैव परफॉर्म अ रोटेशन थ्रू एन एंगल थीटा. सो पॉइंट पी इज नाउ एट अ न्यू पोजिशन क्यू विद अ कोऑर्डिनेट क्यू वन क्यू टू. इनिशियली इट हैज़ अ कोऑर्डिनेट पी वन पी टू. सो एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट को मैंने प्लॉट किया है पी वन, वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज पी टू. सिमिलरली वी हैव अ न्यू कोऑर्डिनेट्स दैट इज क्यू वन एंड क्यू टू. If you understood all this, now as we have performed a rotation through z axis, there will not be change in a z, just like we have done in our classical mechanics. If you remember, z is equal to z dash means there is no change in the z coordinate. That means I can write this as suppose this, as we are discussing on a 3D space, so it is with the coordinates say p1, p2 and p3, and with q with the coordinates say q1, q2 and q3. So I can say this q3 is equal to p3 because there is no change in a z axis. Z is remaining as it is. Okay. Now let us find out what is isometry, and then we will prove that the rotation is also isometry. Okay. So first we will find out what is the coordinates of q1, q2 and q3 in terms of p1, p2, p3. And now we have to find out the rotation matrix. जो भी हमने classical mechanics में किया है, rotation along x, y, z ये perform किया था ना, so the same thing we have to do here also, okay? With some different notations. वहाँ पे हमने x1, x2, x3 लिखा था, यहाँ पे p1, p2, p3 लिखा, okay? Now can anyone tell me what will be cos of theta plus phi from the image? Cos of this side of cos theta plus phi image madhe.
P1 upon Q.
P1 or P2, what it is? Cos of theta plus phi means what? It will be this whole angle, no?
Yes, ma'am, P2.
Okay, just tell me cosine ko aap kya consider karte ho? Adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent means what? What yes, is adjacent side? Now here in this case you have to construct the this triangle. You can have this Q origin O and here, correct? Initial nahi consider kar sakte ho phi wala. You have to construct cos of theta plus phi. Cos of theta plus phi means you have to consider this triangle and then you have to find out cos of theta plus phi with the help of this. What will be the cos of theta plus phi? This is adjacent side. This is what your Q1. Okay. Getting me? Upon R. R is nothing but your position vector of the coordinate. Na? Position to change nahi kiya. Sirf humne just we can say position vector to same hi hoga na, it is having the same distance. Distance humne disturb nahi kiya hai. Point P yahan se yahan change kiya hai, but distance from the origin is fixed out. So you can say this R is fixed out. Yes or no? If cos of theta plus so in this way now actually we want to find out the value of q1, q2, q3 now, because we want what are the coordinates of new position, that is q1, q2 and q3, or we can say the position p to q, it is displaced with an angle theta. So p ke coordinates hame obviously pata honge, you have to just find out q, which is q1 is equal to, I can write r cos theta plus phi. So q1 is equals to r as it is. So we can have this is what, cos theta cos phi minus sine theta sine phi. Now, what is cos phi? What is your cos phi is? You can see the cos phi can be constructed through an angle through this
P1 upon R.
This P1, that is your adjacent side divided by the position vector. That is, I can write it is P1 upon R. So I can write P1 is equals to R cos phi. Okay. So instead of this cos phi, I can now substitute the value P1 upon R. So we get Q1 is equals to R as it is cos theta. Cos phi ki jagah pe hum yahan pe P1 upon R substitute kar sakte, right? Similarly, can you tell me the value of a sine phi?
P2 upon R.
Correct. This is up at opposite side, that is P2 upon the hypotenuse, that is R. Okay, so instead of this one, now I can have the value of a sine phi is P2 upon R. Now here we have to write down the value of a sine phi also. Sine phi will be P2 upon R. So here we get Q1 is equal to RR get cancelled, P1. Cos theta minus P2 sine theta. So in this way we get the value of Q1. Okay. Now similarly we have to find out Q2 also. So can you tell me what will be the value of sine theta plus phi? Just like we have done for our cos theta plus phi. So again you have to construct this triangle. You have to take sine of theta plus phi means this is a opposite side. So this is what your Q2. Correct? Okay, so it is what Q2 upon hypotenuse is R. Hence, now you can write Q2 is equals to R sine theta. What is sine of theta plus phi?
Sine phi cos phi plus cos phi sine theta.
Correct. You can have sine theta cos phi plus cos theta sin phi. Simply angle change karna hai, right? Now again we can have the all those values whatever we have calculated, sin phi and cos phi we have. So my just we have to use those values. What is the value for sin phi? It is P2 upon R, opposite side upon this. And cos phi, what is the value of cos phi? P1 upon R. Q2 is equals to R sin theta, cos phi is P1 by R plus cos theta as it is, sin phi is P2 upon R. Again, if you multiply R inside, you get cancelled. So you get Q2 is equal to P1 sin theta plus P2 cos theta. So in this way, we get the value of Q1, Q2. Similarly, we can get the value of Q3 is equals to P3. And we get the value of Q1 as well as Q2. Okay, let me write down what we get. Q1 is P1 cos theta minus P2 sin theta. Q2 we get it is P2 cos theta plus P1 sin theta. And hence now all these three equations whatever we have got, now we have to write down this in the form of a, we can say it is in the form of a Ax is equals to b. Okay, non-homogeneous equations, right? Which we can write here is a, here is your x. X means what? Those are known one. Known kya hai aapko? P1, P2, P3 pata hai. Correct? And Q1, Q2, Q3 are unknown for us, which we have calculated just now. Now we can write all this in the format of a matrix. So which is firstly cos theta minus sin theta. Check kara te matrix solve karun baga je kai mi lihle barobar aika. Okay, Okay, you have to just write down all these three equation in the form of a matrix AX is equals to B. Okay? Is it correct?
Q1, Q2, Q3 रो मध्ये येईल ना?
रो मध्ये येणार आहे. लेट मी ड्रॉ यू. हाँ, Q1 इज इक्वल टू क्या आएगा? ओके, लेट मी राइट डाउन दिस Q1, Q2, Q3. अगेन वील राइट डाउन इन द मैट्रिक्स. सो वॉट वी कैन राइट, दिस इज वॉट मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस वी कैन राइट, P1 cos theta minus P2 sin theta plus 0. Plus 0 I can skip. Again I can have P1 sin theta plus P2 cos theta, last is 0. Again you can have third one, 0, 0 plus P3. So you got the same, no? Q1 you get P1 cos theta minus P2, Q2 you get P2 cos theta plus P1
yes,
sin theta. Is it okay now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now here we can write this matrix. I will denote it by C. And okay, let me write down here. This is what C, and this is what your point P is equals to Q. So you can say that this is what mapping C of P is equals to Q. We can say that's the rotation of XY plane through an angle theta can be written in the form of a mapping as CP is equals to Q, where what is P and Q? These are points in E3 space, which we can say that C is a matrix of the rotation. Okay, now the mapping will be CP is equals to Q, and hence we can write CP is equals to, that is C of P1, P2, P3 is equal to, we can write it is P1 cos theta minus P2 sin theta. Next is P1 sin theta plus P2 cos theta, and the last is P3. Okay, हे तुमचे Q1, Q2, Q3 आहेत, correct? Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Here we have found the रोटेशन. ओके, रोटेशन से जो हमारा मैपिंग एक्चुअली तैयार होता है. सो वी हैव फाउंड द मैपिंग. नाउ व्हाट इज अवर नेक्स्ट जॉब? वी हैव टू प्रूव इट इज अ आइसोमेट्री. ओके, सो टू प्रूव दैट रोटेशन इज आइसोमेट्री, कैन राइट टू शो दैट और प्रूव दैट सी बार इज आइसोमेट्री. So let's see, is a rotation about a z axis which can be defined as C of P is equals to Q, where P belongs to the E3 space. Let P and P dash be the any two points, which can be written in the form of, say, CP dash is equals to Q dash. Okay, now as we want to find out the isometry, so that's why instead of writing CP and Q, here we have written the two points. क्योंकि हम जब भी isometry check करते हैं तो two points के बीच में check करते हैं ना. But here you may think that P1, P2 घेतलं तर चालेल ना. But here P के coordinates हैं ना आपके P1, P2, P3. So I have written simply P and P dash be the any two points. Let P, P dash be the any two points of E3 space in such a way that CP is equals to Q and CP dash is equals to Q dash. Okay, so now consider distance between CP and CQ. Okay, and our aim is to prove that it is equal to distance between P and Q. Sorry, actually it should be CP and CP dash. P and P dash are the point we have taken, no? You can write CP and CP dash. we want to prove that it is equal to, what is our aim to prove that it is equal to distance between q and q, sorry, distance between p and p dash. And what is this? This is actually distance between q and q dash. Okay. Samasta ite parent?
Yes, ma'am.
Simply now we have to prove it is equal to distance between p and p dash. Now let me use the distance formula. Can write this as q1 minus q1 dash square plus q2 minus q2 dash square plus next is q3 minus q3 dash, it's a square. Now we can have what is q1. Q1 is with the coordinates. What are the coordinates? P1 cos theta minus P2 sin theta minus q1. Q1 dash means what? It will be with the, say we can have P1 dash cos theta minus P2 dash sin theta. Is it correct? Plus, what is the next one? It is with the P1 sin theta plus P2 cos theta minus P1 dash sin theta minus P2 dash cos theta, it's a square. Plus, last, as it is real, as it is, we can write this because both are same, no? P3 minus P3 dash. It's a square because we know that P3 and Q3 are same. Correct, no? Samajhte kay Q1, Q2, Q3 je ahet. Ithe je find kele hote Q1, Q2, Q3. Tej lihle dete. Why? Because Q3 and P3 are same. So simply I have written about Q1 and Q3. Sorry, Q1 and Q2. And similarly, we have written for Q1 dash and Q2 dash. If you're not getting
ma'am, theta plus a
plus a na re
ha
okay fine. Now what you have to do, you have to just take a square and you have to evaluate and you have to prove that it is equal to distance between p and p dash. Can you do this? Okay, let me show you a one shortcut for this one, because to evaluate this one is very difficult. What we will do, this is with P1 cos theta, this is also with P1 dash cos theta. Okay, so let me write down this with P1 minus P1 dash in one, and here we have cos theta minus, if I take this outside, P2 minus P2 dash, and outside is sin theta, and here we have it's a square. करेक्ट, क्या किया है समझ में आया सबको? कॉस थीटा एंड साइन थीटा को कॉमन किया है यहाँ पे. सिमिलरली वी कैन डू फॉर द सेकेंड वन, पी वन माइनस पी वन डैश साइन थीटा इज कॉमन माइनस, इफ आई टेक अ माइनस साइन आउटसाइड सो वी रिमेन्स विथ दिस पी टू माइनस, दिस माइनस माइनस बिकम प्लस पी टू डैश cos theta and outside it's a square plus last term is p3 minus p3 dash, it's a square. Is it okay up to this one? Can you take a square and you can evaluate this now? Squaring kara, evaluate kara, don term cancel honar hai, mag cos square theta plus sin square theta che formula use kara ani mala sanga whether you get distance between p and p dash is same. Can you do this? Is it so difficult to evaluate the square? No one is saying yes.
No, ma'am.
Ah. सॉल्व करा आणि सांगा स्क्वेअर इव्हॅल्युएट करायचं आहे. खूप मोठं नाही काम. काय होणार आहे? पी वन मायनस पी वन डॅश स्क्वेअर कॉस स्क्वेअर थीटा मायनस टू टाइम्स जस्ट लाईक वी हॅव टू इव्हॅल्युएट लाईक ए मायनस बी ब्रॅकेट स्क्वेअर. करेक्ट नो? इव्हॅल्युएट इट एंड टेल मी. Okay, what you do, you solve it and left the meeting. After few minutes, again you have to join with a different link. I am going to take a Scilab. So Kori sir is not here for today. He is on leave. So I will take your second lecture also. I will conduct the practical session Scilab.